So you have heard of HTML before, and what HTML stands for is basically called Hypertext Markup Language. And HTML elements, you can think of them as containers. So you can create an empty container and put content in between. So if I go back to Figma, here we have a container, which is basically an auto layout frame, is renamed to button, and it's in Figma, an auto layout frame. On the left-hand side, you can take a look at a layer panel. Here, if I zoom in, we have a button frame, and then we have a text layer inside of that. So what we can do on the HTML side is we can actually create a HTML element and write our content inside, which is sign up. But you don't have that flexibility in HTML to rename your elements the way you want to. The elements in HTML are preserved, so you have to go by the names that are defined. And the way you create your elements is always starts with a less than sign. Here, if I go ahead and zoom in, you can see that we have a less than sign. And then again, we close that with a greater than sign. And between the less than sign and greater than sign, you put your character. And your character can be basically a preserved HTML element. And then if we go ahead on the closing end, we have less than sign and then forward slash and a greater than sign. And what comes after the forward slash is again the same character that you start with. So for example, if we do want to create a paragraph in our HTML, we start with less than sign and then we have our P paragraph and then we close that with a greater than sign. We put our content in this example, we just write hello world, and then on the far end, we close that with the same paragraph tag, which is the P again. But again, the closing tag is different. So we have less than sign, forward slash, and then greater than sign, and then after the forward slash comes the same character that you start your HTML tag with. And that is how you basically create your paragraph tags. So when it comes to designing, we use a tool called Figma. If I go back here, in Figma we have a layers and pages, and we can simply drag and drop and click our elements to basically select them and move them around. In web development, we use another tool, and it's all text-based. Nothing is created like that in Figma. So we use a code editor, which is called Visual Studio Code. So you can simply search for Visual Studio Code and download it and install it. Again, here you see you'd be able to write HTML, CSS, all types of different languages. And once you download that, you have the Visual Studio Code open and it's going to look like this. And as you can see, you have a text editor. On the left-hand side, you have your sidebar. You have the ability to switch between different tabs here on the sidebar. Also on the bottom left of your screen, you have your settings and profile. You usually would get a welcome screen. So we can ignore that if you click on the X. And once you close that welcome screen, now it is time for us to create our first HTML file. And the way we do that in Visual Studio Code is by clicking on the Explore here. If I go ahead and take a look at the left-hand side, I can click on the Explore. And Visual Studio Code already tells me that I don't have any folder opened. So that's why I don't see that create file icon. So what I need to do is to create a folder on my computer and then open it inside Visual Studio Code. So as you can see, I have created a folder. And then if I take a look at the folder name, as you can see, we have that with all lowercase and no spacing. The best naming convention for your folders is to be basically lowercase and no spacing. It doesn't really matter if you use uppercase or lowercase, but spacing matters. So make sure you don't have any kind of spacing. If you do have a word like in this example, Figma coding, make sure to have a separation like a dash between them. Again, there's nothing wrong with it, but for the best practices, it's better to always have your folder names with no spaces, and if you decide to have two words, you can separate them with a dash. So once I have my folder created, all I have to do is click and drag again on my Visual Studio Code, and then here I do get a pop-up screen again. I'm going to close that, but right now you see on the left-hand side on the Explore, I have my Figma coding open in Visual Studio Code. So what I have to do right now is to create a HTML file. So if I take a look at that, again, if I have my Explore closed, I'm not able to take a look at that, but I do have dragged my Figma empty folder here. So what I would need to do is to click on that Explore tab. And then once I click on that, I now have the ability to click on Create New File. Here now I can create a new file and I can call this Figma. And then what matters is for me to give this file an extension. So if you export something as an image, the extension is most probably going to be .png or .jpg. Or if you have like slides and you export them, it might be .pdf. So here all we have to do is just give it an HTML extension, and the extension is .html. And once I'm happy with it, I'll press return on my keyboard. And now you see I have my HTML file created. So if I take a look at that, you see we have the HTML icon and then we have our icon created. If you don't see that icon or if your Visual Studio Code doesn't look like mine, you don't have your themes customized. So the way you can basically customize your theme in Visual Studio Code is by installing plugins. So if I go back in Figma, if I do want to install something, I can always click on that resources icon. And for example, I do want to install a plugin which is called like Sort Layers. And as you can see, I can click on the plugins and then search for that and then install it and run it. Visual Studio Code works the same. So if you decide to customize your Visual Studio Code theme, you can go to plugins. However, in Visual Studio Code, it's actually referred to as extension. So here, if I take a look at that tiny icon, we are going to install our extensions using this icon. So if I click on that, and if I try to click and drag this, you see I have already a couple of extensions installed. So one of the extensions, if you do want to install it, again, is called Material Icon Theme, and also Material Theme as well. So I can click on these, and I would just go ahead and uninstall them. Let me just also minimize that. So I'll go ahead and uninstall Material Theme and also Material Theme here. I would go ahead and uninstall that. And it tells me to restart. So if I go ahead and restart, you see now my Visual Studio Code looks a bit different. So your Visual Studio Code might look like this right now. Your HTML icon is maybe like this. And then your whole Visual Studio Code now looks gray. So in order for us to install those, again, I can go to Extensions and now I can search for Material and I can click on the install. For example, I would click here and I would take a look at this. Here I can see the icons that this extension gives me, and if I'm happy with that, I would just go ahead and install this. And you see a pop-up appears and it tells me, do you want to use the Visual Studio Code icons or do you want to use the Material Icon Theme? So I go ahead and click Material Icon Theme, and now right now you see my icon has changed as well. So if I go back again to extensions, now I would like to install Material Theme. So I go ahead and click install. And now right now it tells me choose your material theme. So I can go ahead and basically go through them. I have also the ability to choose between light mode and dark mode in this example. And you have again different themes to choose from. I would go ahead and choose Material Theme High Contrast and I would basically select it. And this is how easy it is for me to install themes in Visual Studio Code. And now you see your Visual Studio Code is looking like me, most probably if you are using the same theme, but it really doesn't matter. It all comes down to what preferences and what colors you like to use. Also, another important thing is if I go back to Figma, here you see if you take a look at the left hand side of my screen, if I hold Command and forward slash, again, I have this quick action show up so I can search for example, sort layers, and I can run something in Figma. In Visual Studio Code, we have something like that as well. If you want to see your shortcuts, you can go to basically help. On Mac, I'm basically navigating to help, and then I can click on keyboard shortcut and references. And as you can see, I brought up the shortcut references for both Mac and Windows, and they are basically identical. So if I have to teach you one important shortcut in Visual Studio Code, again, in Figma, if I go back and hold Command and forward slash, it brings the quick action and I can immediately start adding my items and run my plugins. In Visual Studio Code, you have to run something called show all commands, and it is by holding Shift, Command, and P. In Windows, it is the same thing. Instead of Command, it's Control. So Control, Shift, P is the command on Windows. However, in my Visual Studio Code, I have actually customized this command. If you don't have anything open, if you close everything that you have on your Visual Studio Code, the first important command that Visual Studio Code shows you is basically show all commands. And you can see that I have actually customized it to command forward slash because I do want to make sure that it has the same shortcut as my Figma file. And the way you customize your command is basically by going to the shortcut settings. So how do you get to shortcut settings? Again, you have to make sure if this is your first time installing Visual Studio Code, hold Control Shift P. Or if you're on Windows or Mac, you can hold Shift Command P. And as soon as you do that, you would be able to have your search show. Again, in my example, I'm holding Command and forward slash because I customized it. And now you have, again, your search command appearing up top. So what you need to do right now is search for keyboard shortcuts. And then here you have multiple options. Do you want to open the keyboard shortcut, the JSON format? Do you want to have your keyboard shortcut references, which we saw previously on the Windows and the Mac, or do you want to open your preferences and actually open your keyboard shortcuts? So you have to make sure to have preferences selected and open keyboard shortcuts, not the JSON one, because if you open the JSON one, it looks so much different. So make sure to select the preferences, open keyboard shortcuts. And once I do that, here I have a list of keyboard shortcuts selected for me. So now if I go back to my reference, the command is called show command palette. So now all I have to do here is search for show command and then palette. But as you can see, it doesn't show the command palette. So what I need to do is basically delete the word palette. And right now you see it tells me show all commands. And now I have the command, which is show all command, even though on the reference is referred to as show command palette. On the shortcut settings is referred to as show all command. And I actually binded it to command forward slash. And then on the right hand side, it says that I actually modified it. This is not a system modification. This is modified by a user, which is me. And now if I want to have that back to command shift P, I can click on that tiny pen icon and then hold command shift P. Here, as soon as I basically hold command shift P, once I'm done holding command shift P, I can press return on my keyboard. And now right now my key binding has changed. So if I close that and hold command shift P, you see my quick action is changed and it opens when I hold command shift P. So I'm going to revert this back to command forward slash. Again, I would now search for shortcut, and then I do want to open keyboard shortcuts, not the JSON one. And I would search for show command and then click here. And now I would hold command and forward slash. And then by doing that, I press return. And now I have changed my shortcut to command forward slash. And once I'm done with that, I can close this. And now if I do a test, command forward slash, I have exactly the same shortcut as my Figma environment. Also, what you have to keep in mind is if you decide to, for example, change this theme and you don't like it anymore, you can do command forward slash and now search for color theme. And now again, preferences, color theme, I can click on that. And now I have the ability to switch between different themes. Most probably once you install Visual Studio Code, you have one of these default themes. But right now I know how to search for commands on my Visual Studio Code. So I have the ability to switch between them if I ever decide to. Same thing with the icon, I'm gonna escape that. And then if I do command forward slash and search for icon, here you see we have preferences, file icon theme. So I click on that, I have the ability to switch between different icons. Here you see that if I go with different icons, but I do wanna go with material icon theme, which is the one that I just installed. And right now you see the icon goes back to the material icon theme that I selected. So command forward slash is your best friend when it comes to Visual Studio Code. So make sure you customize that to your command, because originally if you have never used Visual Studio Code and you've installed it for the first time, you would have your command as shift command P. So make sure you customize it the same way that you're using Figma.